People throwing bricks right at cop cars. 2020 just wanted to stop.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you even understand who the cops are? We're all human beings with beating hearts.
Yeah.
Living in this world, it isn't easy.
Nope.
Thankful that someday Jesus will free me. I don't know a lot, but I know something.
Yeah.
Racism and hatred gotta stop.
I'd like to think I earn it and my privilege got me nothing, but life isn't as fair to everybody out here hustling. We're living in a fallen world and crying out for justice, full of pain, dropping tears, but the justice isn't coming. I'm praying for change, but the hatred isn't stopping. The nation wants a new order like Amazon shopping. Satan's heir, life ain't fair, the prince of the planet. Nobody can control it and nobody understands it. Only Jesus can save me, God's only son. He'll always love me till my life is
God
done.
Knows his boy was always guaranteed to die for you. Only reason any life matters is cause he gives value. WWJD, when did that stop being asked of you? Black lives matter, how we live our lives matters too. God gave every life meaning, shouldn't be hard to see that that's true. Boys and girls, don't let anyone tell you differently. Jesus loves you.
People throwing bricks right at cop cars. 2020 just wanted to stop.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you even understand who the cops are? We're all human beings with beating hearts. Living in this world, it isn't easy.
Nope.
Thankful that someday Jesus will free me. I don't know a lot, but I know something.
Yep.
Racism and hatred gotta stop.
USA, yeah, this year has got us hurt. An unpopular opinion, we are every bit deserving. Told God get out of school, he's only welcome in church. And is it any wonder all this hatred is emerging? Does it really surprise you we got racism in our nation? Too long we turned a blind eye to structural sins like gentrification. The way we look, how much we know, or how we get that cheddar. People look for something that make them feel like they are better. Self-centeredness is the source for all these sins. We want Satan to leave, but we're so quick to invite him in. People aren't illegal, but we've got illegal refugees. They can't wait 30 years to escape a life of poverty. People dying every day to hatred and to cancer. Refuse to turn to Christ, even though he is the answer. I know nobody wants the smoke, but they willingly choose it and ignore the words God wrote. Let's go.
People throwing bricks right at cop cars. 2020 just wanted to stop.
Yeah, yeah.
Do you even understand who the cops are? We're all human beings with beating hearts. Living in this world, it isn't easy.
Nope.
Thankful that someday Jesus will free me. I don't know a lot, but I know something.
Yep.
Racism and hatred gotta stop.
Fail me now, you won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. And yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Fail me now, you won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. takes. Yes, I will.
Hello and welcome to eYouth Group Week 12. I am Caleb Byron, your host for this evening, and I got a cute little co-host here as well tonight. So go ahead and smash that like button if you think I should adopt. Right now I'm just babysitting, but we're open to the option. These guys are pretty cute. It has been an exciting week here. A lot of things going on in our country. Right now, the reopening of churches is one of the big topics of discussion at our staff meetings. And just thinking about, hey, what is it going to look like when we reopen church on the 14th? That's going to be our first week in a semi-open capacity. And so that's been exciting. Unfortunately, youth group won't be able to open right away. I want it to be fun. And I don't think with the regulations that we have in place right now that youth group would be any bit normal or enjoyable for us. So we're going to hold off on that. But we will be getting together for small groups here in the new format that we have. Over the summer, we're going to be able to get together, more likely the next couple weeks in some small group capacities, which will be exciting. Let's see. Also, we're going to be inviting up our new ninth graders on the 16th. On the 9th, we're going to be having our senior night. We're going to be hearing from our seniors. And another thing I just wanted to share a few thoughts on was just the unrest in our nation right now over the murder of George Floyd. Maybe you've heard nothing about it. Maybe you've heard too much about it. But I wanted to share a few thoughts about what's going on. He's fine. What's going on in our country right now? In Scripture, we hear a few things that I think are excellent pieces of advice. In Micah 6:8, the verse that I had at the end of my video, it says, "He has shown you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? To act justly and to love mercy and to walk humbly with your God." Walking humbly, I think, is a big piece of it, right? Thinking that we're better than somebody else because of the color of our skin or your background or what you do for work or what school you go to. Any of those things is just plain wrong and ignorant. And so we need to be humble in our relationship with other people, in our relationship to the Lord. We should walk in humility. We should seek justice. That's an important thing that we should seek. We should look after those who can't look after themselves. It's very important that we do that. And also we should show mercy to other people and to animals. He's fine. He took a little spill, still landed on his feet. But we should show mercy to other people. One more thing I want to share with you guys, and I think this is really important. John 16:33 says, "I have told you these things so that in me you may have peace." And this is Jesus talking to the disciples before he was going to leave them alone. And things weren't great for the disciples, if you know your Bible history. Jesus says, "In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world." This world is downright rotten. And this week we've seen, just how rotten it could be. Marching and supporting Black lives and coming together to support George Floyd and the way that he was treated wrongly, that's great. Looting and stealing TVs and flipping cars and throwing rocks at police cars, super not okay, right? And so just even thinking back to the verse in Micah, act justly, right? What's right? What's wrong? Jesus tells his disciples that we're going to have trouble, right? We're never promised justice. We're never promised a fair life. Life is going to be downright difficult. And that's been true for me this week. My family has been praying. My grandfather fell last week and is fighting for his life right now. And that's been a pretty difficult thing for my family. And yet we are able to have hope because God gives us hope beyond this life. Someone tweeted this week about the astronauts that left and went out into orbit and hopped on the space station. They said, "Hey, congratulations on leaving Earth, right? Good choice." As believers, we have a hope that we can leave this Earth someday and spend eternity with heaven. And that is what brings me hope, and that is what should bring you hope. And that is the hope that the world desperately needs right now, right? I mean, we can try to achieve justice, we can try to achieve fairness, but it's just not going to happen in this life. We need to achieve sharing hope through the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's the message I want to give to you guys. Thinking about our church opening up in a couple weeks, I got a funny little video here about what we can expect from church as it opens up.
You can't stop it. It's coming to a town near you. It used to be called Contemporary. Some call it relevant. We're so cool, we call it contemporvent.
Young hip guy welcoming all with graphic tee and cool glasses. I welcome everybody with arms wide open, revealing my tattoo so you know I have a past. Quirky transition to band, invite everyone to stand. Let's do it.
This is the song that everyone knows. It's the song that everyone knows. My new song that nobody knows. Nobody knows this song. I want you to learn this song and buy my record in the bookstore after the service.
I just want to invite the ushers up as we prepare for our offering. Feel free to give if you feel led. It's between you and God, but we're tracking it.
One man has all the answers.
I have all the answers.
Showing a picture of a puppy and or a baby from an impoverished third world nation.
Speaking softly to draw you in.
And then emphatically, driving home my point.
On pause. Whispering. Repetition.
Still pausing. Pained expression. Long prayer so that the worship leader can get back on stage.
This is the closing song with strings that'll make you cry.
Coming soon to your town, a new kind of church. You will be lifted high and challenged to grow. We call that Growtivation. You call this Sunday Morning.
All right, real briefly, our announcements for the week are short and sweet. Hopefully you guys like that. We have a new Bible plan that is starting tomorrow. If you're friends with me on the Bible app, I've already invited you, so check that out. We are not gonna be together for our guys' Bible study this week or until we can get together and do a backyard barbecue with appropriate social distancing. We're gonna have that. The ladies' Bible study with Laura Land is still meeting this week on Wednesday. You can contact her if you're interested in hopping in that. And our Thursday night game nights have been canceled due to everyone being Zoomed out. We're gonna have our lesson next. Don't forget to join us on Zoom for small groups. Love and miss you guys.
Romans 12:15 says, this is a command on Christian behavior to the people of God. Romans 12:15, rejoice with those who rejoice, weep with those who weep. My big frustration this past year, as all this stuff flared up across our country, was the widespread lack of empathy and compassion from white Christians towards our African-American brothers and sisters as these things blew up. Now let's chat. Here's my rant. Eye contact. Facts matter. Facts matter. What is true matters. Let's have a little pastoral chat. The timing of those facts also matters, correct? Let me put it in a pastoral place for you so you can see how, I lost my mind on Twitter one day. I just finally snapped. So I'm going to make up an illustration here because I don't want to use someone from our church in a scenario like this. Let's say one of our young families, they didn't house-proof, child-proof their house, and their little nine-week-old little baby was crawling around on the floor, and they picked up a paperclip, and they jammed it into a socket, and the kid died. And then I show up, and I walk into the room, and there the EMTs are putting the body in and getting it out of the house, and mom and dad are wailing. Is that the time for me to begin to say, well, you know, if you house-proof, here's a link to how you house-proof. If you just put this in, how absurd and wicked would I be if in the midst of their sorrow, their loss, their confusion, their anger, I started to talk about how you can avoid that? See how absurd that is? That's why I lost my mind. It's like, shut up. Enter in. Try to understand. Just say, I'm sorry. This is not the time for facts. Facts has its place. Don't email me. Facts come out in time. You give facts time to work. And I don't bring it up that night. You want an easier one than that? How many of you are married? Okay, watch this. This will be a male-dominated issue. Early on in my marriage, Lauren would come and she would say, this is how I feel. And I'd have a list of facts on why she shouldn't feel that way. Now, anybody else? Watch this. Yo, what'd I tell you? Keep your hands up. Now, this is mostly a male issue, right? It's mostly a male issue. So our girls come to us. They're just like, that really hurt my feelings. I can't believe that you would even say that to me. And what do? I'm just give you the facts, boo. Here's the deal. I'm the one that planned this date. You think I planned this date just to bring you out here and insult you at dinner? This was my idea. Remember a couple of weeks ago when I bought you those flowers? You know, you said this, and I said, and you just start laying out the facts. Does that cause the situation to de-escalate, or does it cause it to burn even hotter? What burns even hotter? Has there been a wife in here that as the husband laid forth the facts, they went, you know, I don't feel that way at all anymore. I feel valued and cherished by you. Thank you. Any woman want to raise their hand and go, that's exactly how it happened. Notice not one. Right? Because there's a time and place for facts. And we know this, but for whatever reason, when this kind of ethnic spark thing happens, all of a sudden white people, they're all about the facts. But the Bible says, no, you mourn with those who mourn. You mourn with those who mourn. You enter in, you try to understand. Hey, listen, it's fine if you don't understand. But if you don't understand, it probably shouldn't be Lincoln crap to your Facebook page. If you don't understand, you probably should keep your mouth shut. In fact, I think there's a whole bunch of Proverbs that goes, hey, you best to just shut your mouth and open it and reveal that you're a moron. That's a paraphrase. If you try to look in your thing, moron, oh, it's not coming up, all right? It's a paraphrase. It's in there. All right, there's a time to just be quiet if you don't understand and not berate and beat people up with facts that you found on the internet, which is a problem in and of itself, right? Truth has a place. Truth takes time. While we wait, we empathize. While we wait, we seek to understand. While we wait, we mourn with those who mourn. That's the distinctively Christian way to behave. And we had a shot, and by and large, we blew it.